الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونشكره نستعين به جل وعلا ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ به سبحانه وتعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. عباد الله، أنصحكم ونفسي الآثمة بتقوى الله، أحثكم وإياها على طاعته، أحذركم وإياها وبال مخالفته ومعصيته. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا مولانا محمدا صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله، أرسله بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره الكافرون. اللهم صلي وسلم وبارك على هذا النبي الأمين الأمي الطاهر الزكي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. أما بعد، يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى في المحكم بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: ولا تقولوا لمن ألقى إليكم السلام لست مؤمنا تبتغون عرض الحياة الدنيا. الآية أزرلي إن سورة النساء and the ayah in Allah, in this ayah Allah says وَلَا تَقُولُوا لِمَنْ أَلْقَى إِلَيْكُمُ السَّلَامُ لَسْتَ مُؤْمِنًا. It means do not say to those who say to you salam, do not tell them لَسْتَ مُؤْمِنًا, you are not a mu'min, or do not call them not mu'mins, or do not take away what appears basically on their superficial limbs and tongue, etc., etc. A major principle of the message of Islam is tolerance and intercultural bettering of the human relations. يعني النبي الأعظم صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم came with the message of mercy. And the mercy was not only restricted to a certain tribe or a certain place in geography or is even a certain species. Verses, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. And many people translate it as mankind. Al-alamin does not only mean mankind, it means every creation that Allah created. Al-Habib al-A'zam sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam is a mercy to it, whether it's living or non-living, whether it's rocks or wood or trees or animals, human beings, Martians if they were, whatever it is, Al-Habib sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a mercy to the planets and to the stars sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. So therefore the message of mercy and tolerance and the call for human rights that Islam initiated as a continuation to the message of the prophets before him. يعني عيسى or Jesus عليه السلام also came with that message. Moses, Musa came also, Nuh, Ibrahim, etc., etc. And Islam stressed on two things: education and intercultural competence. Why? Number one, education. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, the first ayah that was revealed, اقرأ, read. Basically, learn. Huh? This is a message to the Ummah. So we have to read, we have to be educated. And therefore Islam instituted free educational systems for all the people that are around the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the Sahaba, some of them, al-Kiram radiallahu anhum, some of them were old, some of them were young, some of them were Arabs, some of them were non-Arabs, yet all provided education in an atmosphere where human rights were emphasized. What do I mean by this Islamic atmosphere or Islamic context of human rights? I mean by it is a climate. A climate in which tolerance and respect for human dignity is not only taught but also practiced, where equality and justice are basic minimum requirements. This is what Islam came with. This is the message of tolerance. Therefore, among the destructors of any society and the destroyers of any society, among them the Islamic society, would mean the lack of tolerance, almost an idol, the lack of tolerance or intolerance and aggression. الايه talks ولا تقولوا لمن القى اليكم السلام لست مؤمنا. Do not call those who say salam to you, are you not a mu'min? Why? As if الشريعة talks to people. And this is always renewing. A valid in every time. As if you see people nowadays, they say he's a mu'min, he's not a mu'min, he's a Muslim, he's not a Muslim, he's this, huh? And you have people who call people infidels, and you have people who call people of shirk and bid'ah and kufr, and they are distributing labels right and there. While Al-Quran Al-Kareem says, لا تقول, do not call those who say as-salam, لست مؤمنا, you're not a mu'min. How do you know? Do you know what's in their hearts? طيب. أسباب النزول, المفسرين had actually different opinions on أسباب النزول, but there is sort of a general idea is some of the Sahaba went and there was a man from Bani Sa'yani, actually let's not mention the exact story, but they killed a man. Man, this man, when they said La ilaha illallah, he also said La ilaha illallah. Huh? Some people accused him of just saying it so he doesn't, he escapes punishment or escapes whatever. So therefore they killed him. They went back to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam saying that this man said this but he still was killed. And النبي صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم was extremely angered by this. So that the man who was among the people who killed him said, Ya Rasulullah, استغفر لي, Ya Rasulullah, make استغفار for me. And Imam al-Qurtubi al-Razi mentions, he says, how can I? And the man said, لا إله إلا الله. كيف? It wants to show us that there must be dignity for the human being, for that human life, the worth that Islam confers on every single creation Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created. Where people don't go and start locking people in Jahannam, because we have this habit, of course that habit has developed over the years, where people take on themselves the charge of assigning certain group to Jahannam and assigning other group to Jannah and locking this one in Jahannam and throwing the key away as well. And saying this is kafir or this is not kafir or this is shirk or this is bid'ah or this is kufr without anything and without even going back to the basic principles of what? Of actually understanding first and opening up a dialogue. Therefore, moving on now to some of the meanings of the ayah. لا تقول لمن ألقى إليكم السلم أو السلام عفوا لست مؤمنا. السلام هي, the مفسرين said, this is who people say أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. كلمة السلام, كلمة الإيمان, لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله, that's it, سلام. If someone says أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمد رسول الله, you are not obligated to search their hearts, nor can you judge their intentions by their deeds. You are to take them as face value, and Allah is the knower of the hearts, not you. Other mufassirin say kalimat as-salam, alqa ilaykum as-salam, really is not necessarily ashhadu an la ilaha, but it is as-salamu alaykum. That someone came and said assalamu alaikum. And then if someone says assalamu alaikum, do not call him not mu'min. Or do not call him not, you are not Muslim, you are not a mu'min, you are not a believer. No? You don't know what's in the hearts of people again. No, other tafsir said, assalam really is the ones who come to you and they surrender to you. Yani someone said, I'm surrendering, I have no problem with you. I want to be at peace with you. لا تقول لهم لست مؤمنا, you're not a believer as well. Now there's another narration by Abi Hamza al-Khalaf and other narrators of this ayah. ولا تقول